6:35?
I'll make a motion that we seat Erica for Lou Timmerlin.
I'll second it.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, any comment from the public?
Nope.
Okay, reports. Secretary's report.
It was a wonderful report, as always, very thorough.
I think the board's really lucky that you have a very active alternate here that comes to your meetings and what's going on.
Make a motion that we receive the secretary's report as presented.
Anybody second?
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, the treasurer's report.
She emailed it, right?
Yes, I didn't bring it, but I looked at it.
All looks good, I'm so glad as well.
What do you think?
We're talking about the monthly.
Yep, from Linda.
Budget and the revenue.
Hey. Yes, we have to.
See her and see her for John.
I'll go home.
You stay.
Get through the.
Oh, wait, hold on, don't.
No, that was her mom.
Oh, okay.
No.
Get through the treasurer's report.
Yeah, I have a comment, actually. I would like to see on the monthly report, all the accounts listed, including the specific reserve accounts. My understanding is that they're not on here, but am I not correct in that?
Yeah, the reserve accounts don't change much because they, unless the Board of Finance agrees to let it go to town meeting, then they're going to stay the same, I guess, except for the interest. And I don't know how, I think she may only get the interest on those accounts quarterly, maybe.
The money cannot be taken out of them by law. Unless, well, that's not quite true. The money that's put in a given fiscal year, the amount that's put in within a given fiscal year can be taken out without any further action because it's appropriate for the year. But the amount that is built up in past fiscal years can't be taken out without going to town meeting.
Right.
Because even though we appropriated putting in, the Office of Management Policy says that spending is for a fiscal year. So if we appropriate some to put in, it could be, so it could change by that much. But generally, the reserve accounts are to build up a lot more than we put in 1 year. And then.
It is here anyway.
No, I'm talking about the other reserve accounts.
Which, you're talking about the 107 Main Street, the fire commission equipment, all those reserve accounts?
Yes.
They're here. On this part right here, the monthly object report, if you turn to page 5.
Is that?
They are listed.
Sorry, which file was that?
This would be the monthly object report.
No, I don't think that's sent. I don't think that was sent.
Expenditure report.
Oh, the expenditures?
No, I've got this monthly object report that is on too. I don't know if it's on the expenditure report.
Well, here, is that it right there?
Anyway, my recommendation is that we just put it on the summary page at the very front so we can see it listed with all the other accounts. And so, even though there's no change,
Well, it could be.
It help, well, even though there's, you know, there might be or there may not be, we can at least have a snapshot of everything.
And what has she been doing, like an annual?
Well, no, general fund accounts.
Has she been giving us an annual summary of them?
Non-recurring capital accounts is also on the monthly expenditure report on page, oops, I don't know what page that is. It's the third page in.
And that shows the total, not just this year's?
It just, non-recurring capital accounts, it just shows this year's, what's in all of them. It doesn't break it down into. It doesn't put it in each one.
Yeah.
But this one does. The monthly object report does break it down and it shows what was put in.
So maybe if that one were added to her normal distribution.
And see, nothing has been taken out, well, over under budget, if something was taken out, then it would show here, but nothing has been taken out, so.
I'm sure there's no problem in adding it.
Sure.
But just for your information, yes, the selectmen could expend what is put in within the year that is part of building up the overall amount, but could not expend more than that.
The other thing that, and are you looking for the total amount in each account, or are you just looking for what was put in for this fiscal year?
I'm just trying to get a sense of where all monies have been assigned.
Okay.
That's all.
Well, then this would tell you where the monies have been assigned here on the object report, and that tells you exactly the amount of money that was put into each of these accounts.
Each of those accounts.
Accounts for this fiscal year, and those are all of the ones.
And the total, or just what was put in?
Just what was put in.
Well, maybe what I can do is then after this meeting, I can see if I've got it on the reports that
we
sent.
We don't get that.
Okay, yeah. We don't get them, okay.
So you have
don't you have, you, so you then, don't have it in your packet?
So then my recommendation is that we just have them summarized on the front page like they are on the reports that are sent out to us.
Yeah, I don't know why I got this.
Because then they'll be included with all the other accounts. And we'll know which bank account it's in, how much money, etc.
Because it's kind of an unknown.
Yeah.
No, you have a good point, because especially for me who is new on this, it's good to have an easy accessibility to where everything is, because I'm still unclear on certain things, so it is a good point.
So do we need a motion for that, or is that just a request?
Why not? I'll move it.
I'll second.
Request that of the treasurer.
Any discussion?
So you just want Linda to add it on the monthly treasurer's report?
Yes.
Okay.
And a summary. Reserve account summary.
If there's no further discussion, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Now I'll make a motion that we receive the treasurer's report as presented.
Second that motion.
All in favor?
So are we going to do something about
you're going to have to see
making the motion.
Yeah, because Lou was... Yeah. So we do the motion to see her for John.
Yeah, I'll withdraw my motion.
Well, but John isn't here.
Yeah, well, I know, but we have to move before you came in, they seated her for you.
So you can't be here twice, although... I'm withdrawing the motion for the receiving the treasurer's report. I am making a motion that we unseat Erica
for Lou.
Lou. And reseat Erica for John.
Just have to move her seat.
Somebody else second this, because it doesn't get
confused.
Okay.
We have to approve that motion now.
Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Now back to what I was saying before. I'm going to go on this meeting, I guess. I make a motion to receive the treasurer's report as presented.
Second.
That's John.
Right, that's
any,
John.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. For those opposed, could you say something?
I said second. I said aye.
Oh, okay. Tax collector's report.
Receive the tax collector's report as presented.
Second that motion.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Board of Ed report. There was nothing in the mailbox.
I didn't get anything in the email.
Move table to next meeting.
What's this right here?
Yeah, well, you got something. Isn't there a profit law sheet that's looking for this?
That's right.
Okay.
All right, so we should all...
And let's see, how can I get it?
You should have went first.
That's month end.
Would you go this year for outdoor ed?
Nature's classroom?
I'm not really a spokesperson yet, but...
Do you have any idea?
They went to Nature's classroom.
No.
They went to Nature's classroom.
Can you explain account number 3200201? Just kidding.
Wow, what happened with the transport bus contract?
Was renewed.
Oh, I see.
And they had a real good deal until last year when it was renewed. But they did do some things, as I understand it, with combining, if a bus from North Canaan, for instance, was going right down Route 7, then that bus would pick up kids from, They did it more on a regional level. It's the same going down Route 7 coming from Kent. If there were kids in Cornwall along the way and the bus has room, they picked them up too.
That's how they eliminated one bus or something?
And yeah, they tried to do it on a more regional basis where they could. And I don't know how they figured that out town by town, but...
Smart.
Yeah.
Have we gotten something like this before?
Yeah.
Since when?
A few months back.
You didn't get any, you haven't had any in a few months because they're closing up books for the end of the other fiscal year.
Well, this is very good.
This is what you get all the time. If you don't print it out, you can't.
When we get it, I guess.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Yeah, no, I think so, it was a little late.
Yeah. And you guys...
It's not consistent.
Yeah, somebody...
We made a special request.
Carried a complaint back.
Right. From last meeting.
This is really easy to do, this is QuickBooks, I think. Once you set it up, just manage the buttons. Get right in there.
Anybody move to receive it?
I'll move to receive it.
I'll second.
Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? I have this monthly department report. There was one copy in the box. Is that something that needs to be copied, distributed, or?
That's yours. That's just your, I think that's just Board of Finance and what you spent, I believe. I think Linda just gives it to the chairman so that you know where you are. Yeah, this is just your budget and where you are, and you haven't spent very much money so far. You've only spent
2.68%.
Yeah, something like that. It's very little. Your big expenses will come when you are paying for the audit, which is $13,400, and then you have to pay for the printing of the annual report, typing and printing of the annual report. So those are the big expenses.
Trip to Las Vegas.
Yeah.
Let's party there or something.
Okay. First selectman's report.
Yeah. It's been fairly quiet since we last met, but we are moving closer and closer to the finish of the project over at 103 Main Street. The Department of Social Services did. We had $50,000 left that had to be given to the town. They put $40,000 of the $50,000 in. They hold back $10,000, which I think it amounts to, what, 5%? I think it is 5% of the total grant of $200,000. When they are almost ready to finish, I will make a. I've already talked to Jim Marsh, my contact at the ESS, and he'll make an appointment to come out and see it. They do like to inspect, and I'll make sure that not only am I with them, but we'll have Megan Coachman from Alley, who are kind of the construction managers, for lack of a better word. I'll make arrangements so that she can be there too, so that he understands exactly what was done, because some things have been done over there that wasn't paid for by the steep grant. You know, for instance, when he comes in, he'll see a relatively new roof. That wasn't done through steep grant funds. But there's a lot of things that were done through steep grant funds. And as far as I know, the Children's Theater group has been able to raise the extra amount of money to do the vestibule. You must be part of that, because I see you over there.
Yeah, I have reversed the doors for them, but I said that I wasn't going to give them a bid on doing the vestibule until they gave me directions, because they initially asked me to give them an estimate to fix it.
Yeah, so but you don't know how they want it fixed.
Yeah, and there's some thresholds there that have to be dealt with and some other issues. So we have to, before I give them an estimate, we have to conference.
Right.
To find out what they want done. The last thing that I heard is they want to waterproof that oak floor.
I'm pretty sure that that's what they want to do, because those doors,
exterior doors, are going to be removed.
That's right. That's correct. Yes.
Because they're non-compliant. They don't open out, and they can't open out because there's no...
Yeah. That was the only way that they could get the fire egress, was to do it the way they're doing it, which means taking off those doors, which I, from what I can gather, aren't the original doors anyway.
I don't believe they are.
And if you look at it from the inside out, it looks like those doors are curved, but they're not curved, because they put a piece above the doors. They kept the curve on it, but the doors are actually rectangular. And it looks nice, but they really aren't curved, which actually is a benefit for them, because if they have to replace those doors with curved doors, it costs them.
So it looks curved until you open it, and then you see the corners come with it?
That's right. Oh. When the doors are closed up, it looks like the old-fashioned.
Yeah.
And from what I gather, this version of the Methodist Church was probably done in the early 1900s, I think, because there was a fire there that burned 107 and right down through. But I think I don't know if they list this version as 1840s, but I think there was some damage in the early 1900s. But they're working on it, and from what I am gathering from Scott Clemens, they're almost there to what they think it's going to cost to do it. But that part isn't going to be part of the grant money,
right?
Because it'll exceed the total amount that we have left in the grant. There's not going to be enough to pay for that. We might be able to use some of the money from the grant, depending, to pay for part of it, but not all of it. So I guess that's something that they're working on. The library steep project is moving along pretty well. We've checked everything out, and we did not have to have three bidders on that, as long as we advertised it, which we did, twice in the Hartford Courant, twice in the Lakeville Journal. Millennium, got it right this time.
There you go.
Millennium Builders was a low bidder on that, and George Johansson, engineer from Allied Engineering, has checked out their references, done everything, and is beginning to work with them. By the way, they got very, very, very high grades in terms of their work from the people that we contacted who had worked with them before. Even our building inspector complimented them on their work. He's dealt with them in North Canaan. And his church in Norfolk, I think, used that for something, so he has the other side of the coin where he was kind of the customer.
What's the name of it again?
Millennium. And actually, Millennium is owned by the brother of the fellow who is doing the work over here. It is Tom Carey's brother who owns Millennium. He's out of, I think he's out of Rocky Hill or someplace, but very, very reasonable. Very reasonable. And so that's moving along. They wanted to do, I know the guy that is going to be subcontracted to do the excavation work would really like to get it done before the snow flies, but he will be subcontracting under
Millennium.
Good, thank you. And he actually did all the drainage and excavation work at 103 and did a great job. So if he's a subcontractor, that will be a good job done on that. So we're working on that. As far as the $200,000 steep grant for the fire department, the building committee is almost ready to present an alternate plan for that to the membership of the fire department. There's a few loose ends that have to be tied up. They were supposed to be meeting tonight, but did you get the message?
No.
That meeting got canceled. No, I guess they couldn't raise a quorum because Kent and I are two members of that committee, and we were going to be here, not over there. So. But hopefully we may have some forward movement on that, but again, the fire department will have to come back to the town for a financial support for a portion of that building, so we'll see. I think everything else is going along pretty well. I did want to mention the Water Street, the Iron Bridge. You had asked how we were going to be able to, what the formula was for paying for that. Curtis, from what Curtis could find out, and I asked him to give me a name, but he's been very busy over there with his own town on some of that. But I talked to him last week, and we still think it is, as I spoke to you about, that it will be based on the grand list. And if it's based on the grand list, there's 20% of the project that the two towns have to pay for. That 20% that has to be paid for by the towns is based on a formula that we believe is tied directly to the grand list.
That would be the same as last time.
Right. And if that is the case, then Salisbury's share is going to be quite a bit larger than the town of Canaan's share, just because their grand list is so much larger than our grand list. I don't want to give you any definitive numbers, but in Curtis and I talking together about it, even if it was like a $2 million project, 80% of that will be paid for, remaining 20%. I told him I had been telling the Board of Finance that my best guess was between $100,000 and $200,000. Curtis felt that I was right on track with that, and that it will probably be, we think it'll be significantly less than the $200,000. So, but you know, the engineering is still being done on that, and nothing will go fast with that.
Right.
Because they have to make some decisions about how they're actually going to repair that bridge. There has been, I don't know if they're going to, make the repairs to that bridge and leave the bridge where it is, then they have to do a whole lot of things to protect the river with this whole, like this drape thing underneath it.
Like they did over in
right.
On the Iron Bridge.
Right. So I think that they're running some cost estimates about that, getting all that in place to catch all the, you know, anything that would come off that bridge. I think they're comparing that to actually taking the bridge apart and doing everything off site, painting it, doing everything off site.
That was done somewhere else too.
Yeah.
They skidded the bridge off. In another place, a bridge that size wasn't actually taken apart. it was dragged, you know, cribbed up and dragged over to one side.
Yeah.
And worked on more or less in its entirety, but without it being taken apart.
Right, so they are also looking at that, they are also looking at that possibility. And I think that what will be done there will be whatever is most cost effective.
Yeah.
And when do we expect to have the...
Well, I told you about 15 months ago that it was going to be a 36 to a 38 month project. So I would say we've got at least another 14 to 18 months before that bridge will be back up and running.
If
everything goes all right.
We still have to submit that stuff to Washington.
Yep.
And through the state. You know, all this bureaucratic transaction has to occur before one rivet is addressed.
Right.
I'm sorry, what did you say, 14 to 18 months?
From now.
Engineering or the completion?
The completion.
Oh,
which would be...
Maybe a little optimistic.
Maybe.
So like 6 months more for the engineering than...
Well, it may be 6 months for the engineering and trying to get Washington to approve it, the federal government to approve it. Because remember this, although it's called the State Bridge Grant, it really isn't a state bridge grant. The state gets it from the federal government, and the state has to answer to the federal government, so it makes it the whole process a little bit more complex.
And part of that is, for the bridge being in place, with the bureaucratic definition of being functionally, quote-unquote, functionally obsolete, because it's one lane. But the car count and some other factors can be used to waive that. Mm-hmm. But still,
it all adds to the time it takes to decide.
Because somebody then has to say, well, even though normally we don't allow money to be spent on a functionally obsolete bridge, this isn't really functionally obsolete because this car count is fewer than 400 a day, and all of that has to traffic up and down through Washington.
And let's hope that they approve it, because
give us the waiver.
Well, it's approved up to the point that we are at this point. They've given us the okay to go forward. Mm-hmm. But who knows what they're going to do when it gets to Washington? Who knows? I mean, I don't think that the state would have allowed us to continue with the process if they didn't have a decent feeling that this was going to be approved. I think that the states, whatever argument the states makes, will go a long way.
Well, the central one is that the alternative for the two-lane bridge, which requires every idea of compliance, including the sight lines and the intersection, involves building a whole new bridge in a different location. Mm-hmm. And that would be millions of dollars, and the biggest thing in our favor right now is that the government's broke. They could save a lot of money by doing it the common
This could be, like $2 million compared to like $12 or $14 million to build a new one. And it would, and to try to find the location to do it, put the piers in the river, I mean, you're talking...
Insane.
Yeah, you're talking major stuff, and, 36 months will look like a bargain.
Yes.
Now, can I ask a question? Now we had the other state grants that were submitted. Did you hear anything?
But I will tell you, mm-hmm. the governor has started to make some announcements about some of these state grants. So, it looks like he's doing it the same way he did it last year, where he goes around to the various communities and does it. But I've only heard of him visiting one or two places, and the grants I think were given for some kind of housing. Mm.
Yeah.
Even though there are housing grants out there, I think that what I heard is good for housing. But to answer your question, no, we have not heard about that. And we have another one from the library. We had to rate them. We had to put them in order. Mm-hmm. And
we're not first.
You're not first. The Falls Village Canaan Historical Society is first to try to shore up the steeple and do what has to be done over on that historic building. The library is second. Third was the fields and facilities, but we never over at the high school.
Okay.
But we never put that grant never got put together, even though we approved it and it never got put together. And the other one is for the children's theater. It's a small one, $50,000 specifically for insulation. So really, we thought we were going to submit four. We ended up submitting three.
Okay.
It wouldn't surprise me if the Children's Theater got it, because it's a very modest amount of $50,000 as compared to, $200,000 or $300,000 or $400,000.
Yeah.
So, but we haven't heard of that.
Okay.
We still We still do not have anybody to be the representative of the Torrington Area Health District. And I don't know, Louis, if you would be interested in being the representative there. Fred, yeah.
I, how many times does the media?
I think they meet once a month.
I would try it.
Okay.
And see what my family says and how it turns out.
Okay, so why don't you get back to me?
Okay.
And we don't mind calling a special meeting. We're gonna probably have to have a special meeting after tonight's special meeting.
We call it provisional.
Okay, all right.
And then we'll see.
Okay, so we could, if we wanted to, we could approve you tonight if we needed, it's on the.
As a provisional.
Okay.
And see, we'll see how it goes.
Okay.
I heard it.
You heard that, remember that? All right, that would be great. And then I can let them know that you're gonna try it and see if it fits into your schedule. Okay, that's good. We are ready, we've got the permission from all the people on Page Road to do some drainage underneath the road. So when Tim is ready to do that, I will just notify them and we'll get that underway. We have completed the, interviews for the highway maintainer position and we'll be discussing our next step at tonight's meeting. Hopefully by this time next month, somebody will be in place there. And unless you've got something, I don't. Oh, the other thing is, one more thing, is that we did approve Michelle McGuire as our emergency operations manager.
Oh, this person here?
This person here.
Okay.
And that radio's in there and the computer's in there too. But most of her paperwork will be here and then.
Also,
I want to try to do something with this cubby where maybe we can set up another counter space on this side and Ernie and Mike O'Neill can have one counter space and the other counter space can be for, you know, for the radios in there. So, and Michelle, by the way, we really kind of threw her into it. I had her be part of the last week's disaster with the snowstorm and also with Hurricane Sandy.
That's so kind of you.
Yes, and she did a really. We just threw her into the fire. I said I'm just going to throw. You know, it's going to be baptism by fire. So she came to all the meetings that Tim and it was Tim, myself, and Michelle had with Randy Vagnini, who is our representative from CLMP. She did a really good job with him, actually went on the road with him to show him different locations and areas, did a really good job. We also have a list of people that we want to contact during emergencies to make sure they're okay. If anybody in the community can actually think of someone that might want to be checked on, you know, especially if we have a lot of down wires or a lot of power loss, just please let me know, because we have a team together. The fire department has always done that, but we're going to be a little bit more specific and not just have that, not just have those names in our head.
What would you call that?
It's just to check on them to make sure that they're okay if they need to be moved or to come to the firehouse or to the shelter, that they can do that. If we need to get them to a relative's house.
Is this for the whole? You know, by neighborhood, like we check on a few people we knew in our neighborhood. And
right.
I talked to Linda about it, but by neighborhood, I would.
I'm talking about the whole town. I'm talking
now,
about the whole town.
A question.
We are a neighborhood. The way I look at it.
Yeah. What happens when someone decides that they don't want to leave?
That's up to them.
Unless there's some pending.
By statutes, the first selectman actually has the authority to call an evacuation or whatever you want to call that. This first selectman would do absolutely nothing without consultation with emergency services, because they by far know more about conditions and so forth than I could ever know. I mean, I know some, but
yeah.
But the authority does lie with the executive authority. And I would also, obviously, the board of selectmen would be in that decision too.
Well, were you? Just inquiring whether the full depth of your question might cover an instance in which this checker, this person, whatever you're calling this, finds someone seriously compromised in reference survival, but does not want to leave.
Well, then what we would do is, obviously you try to convince them, but what we would do is we would contact the DEMAS 5 region and talk about different strategies with them, if they have family, to try to get their family to convince them to do it.
So that comes back to you then, that checker,
right.
Back to you.
Right.
And then, I mean, yeah, I guess this is all detailed.
And we've had something similar like that last October, and Sharon Hospital actually kept the person in question, because that person was gonna end up coming here because of the steps that could not be negotiated upstairs to the firehouse. So I would have been here with that person, with a cot or whatever, but it turned out that the hospital thought the condition was serious enough to keep the person there for a couple of days.
Thank you for your attention.
I think that's it, unless you guys have any questions.
Thank you very much, Pat.
Welcome.
I'm not aware of any communications from the mailbox. Anybody else know of any?
I actually thought, Jenny and I are looking at each other, because we were at the Board of Education meeting last week, and I think I made clear you can...
I thought a letter was coming.
Yes, there were several letters that were supposed to be coming back to the Board of Finance, and I did remind them that the meeting was, didn't I? I know I did. I did remind them that the meeting was this Monday night, so...
Was this about the technology, or...
Yes, it was about establishing a technology fund plus the...
And a procedure for funding.
A procedure for funding a couple of non-capital recurring accounts.
There being nothing here, move for adjournment.
Wait a minute, I do have a question. I remember back in, I could look in my notes, August perhaps, that we were going to talk with, or at least offer our services to talk to the Board of Education before budget time?
Yeah, and I gave them that message.
Okay, because I think
that message was given to them that same...
It would be nice to follow up on that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I gave them that message, I mentioned it again. I don't know. I think that what the Board of Education is trying to do, as you know, Maria Folsom is retiring at the end of December, and I think they are trying to, and you were at that meeting too, so feel free to chime in anytime. But my understanding is that Maria was going to have that the budget for fiscal year 13-14 pretty much set before she retired. Jenny may have to do part of it, but it was the bulk of it was going to be completed, as I understand it. But I thought they were going to be here tonight. So I don't know what happened.
But Jenny, the one thing that we did say, and we've been going back and forth about, is that we're asking them to make a fair estimate of the real costs of everything, and not lowballing the cost to keep. To keep from making one change where they might make it, where some people think they might, and then looking for underspending somewhere else to be transferred to their account. So if the building, for example, the building maintenance, if some amount is the logical amount to be retained every year for the building, it made us uneasy to see that underestimated, and then to use a refund from somewhere else to take care of it, not to lowball that and say, in other words, the essential things that have to be done that are non-programmatic, that you have to maintain the building, really wanted a fair, actual, realistic estimate of those up front, and not hoping for money at the back end to make up for a lowballing it. Am I right?
Yeah, I think that the Board of Finance was looking for a appropriate figure in that non-reoccurring fund in their proposed spending plan. And then at the end of the fiscal year, if they did have some unexpended funds and wanted to add more to it, then at that time the Board of Finance would take that under consideration. But from my point of view, the Board of Selectmen are expected in our non-reoccurring capital accounts, and that's what you were talking about earlier in the meeting. We are expected to fund those in an appropriate amount, and we do. It's part of our proposed spending plan. But if we can, at the end of the fiscal year, we've come back to the Board of Finance before it's not the annual town meeting, but it's the annual budget hearing or meeting, whatever you want to call it. And we ask if there are certain amounts left in certain line items or certain categories, we ask for up to amounts to be transferred at the end of the fiscal year and be put into specific non-recurring capital accounts. So I don't think the board has any objection to doing that, so long as they are putting a proper number in the actual spending plan in the beginning.
Well, the other thing that we were confronted with is that a certain other town just automatically takes some on the unexpended money, not from the local account, which you can do by statute, you know, move things around inside, but it's refunded to the general fund, say, from the region. and some other town automatically takes money that's refunded to the general fund without an appropriation and funnels it over somewhere else. Well, our understanding from OPM is that that's not legal. And, but aside from that, our auditor also would find that a deficiency of management. So that when the money comes back to the general fund, it can't be taken out of there to augment a year where it wasn't put in an account to begin with. It has to be appropriated, and that's the procedure that Pat describes with some things that are done by underspending at the end of a fiscal year to, say, augment the fire engine account or what have you. And we've been pressured on that because such and such other town does that, and we don't comment on that town's
going. Well, I think Jenny can attest to the fact that I mentioned that the town that was mentioned, I said, well, this is the way the town of Canaan does it. This is the way we've been told by our auditors to do it.
More than that, we've been told by OPM that it's not lawful to do it otherwise because appropriations are annual for the fiscal year in which for which they're made.
And OPM is the Office of Policy Management. They have a group of people there that do nothing but the sort of thing, you know, look at these sorts of things and help us with questions among a lot of other things. Over the years, we've talked to attorneys that are on that staff about this very issue. So we're pretty confident, and I think our auditor is pretty confident that the way we are doing it is the appropriate way to do it. And I think they had a total of three letters that they were going to.
Three letters, and I don't know specifically the details of all of this. I'm just figuring this out, which is why I came tonight, just to kind of get a sense of.
Well, this should help.
To start to hear the language.
Yeah.
It was very thoughtful of you to come, by the way.
And they do have some other ideas, but rather than me trying to repeat it, I would rather have them present it to you directly, because I don't want to get it messed up, and they can present their ideas to you directly. You already have two of the things that they want, so, but there is a third issue that they want. The issues that they brought to you is creating a non-recurring capital account for technology, and Maria came to your last meeting with a more updated thing on the technology, so you probably have a better idea about that. And the other item that they came to you about was somehow taking what was not expended from the high school budget and transferring it, and that's a bit of a problem from what I understand, because we never get any money back into the general fund. It's a credit to our bill over there. So something that's going to have to be worked out. So
move to adjourn.
We haven't done.
Well, that
that was communications.
Well, that kind of fit into old business. Yeah, is there any other old business anybody wants to bring up? Or new business? I'm sorry, what was that you were saying?
I forgot. Someone else. I did twice. Someone else.
Go ahead, Erica, do it.
Motion to adjourn.
Anybody second?
I'll second that.
Hello.